Good morning, and thank you for joining us today. For those of you who are visiting, welcome to Transfiguration. Our presider today is our new pastor, Father Eric Hill, and Mass is concelebrated by our new parochial vicar, Father Miller. Please rise and join us in singing as we begin our celebration.
Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
as we gather this morning, let's take a moment to seek God's mercy and peace.
You came to heal the contrite of heart. Kyrie eleison.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. Thanks for your great glory.
us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. From the book of the prophet Ezekiel. As the Lord spoke to me, the Spirit entered into me and set me on my feet. And I heard the one who was speaking say to me, Son of man, I am sending you to the Israelites, rebels who have rebelled against me. They and their ancestors have revolted against me to this very day. Hard of face and obstinate of heart are they to whom I am sending you. But you shall say to them, Thus says the Lord God, and whether they heed or resist, for they are a rebellious house, they shall know that a prophet has been among them. The word of the Lord.
I will lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where shall my help come from? My help shall come from the Lord who made heaven and earth.
I will lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where shall my help come from? My help shall come from the Lord who made heaven and earth.
Second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, that I, Paul, might not become too elated because of the abundance of the revelations, a thorn in the flesh was given to me, an angel of Satan to beat me, to keep me from being too elated. 3 times I begged the Lord about this, that it might leave me. But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness. I will rather boast of my weaknesses in order that the power of Christ may dwell in me. Therefore, I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and constraints for the sake of Christ. For when I am weak, then I am strong. The word of the Lord.
From the Gospel according to Mark. Jesus departed from there and came to his native place, accompanied by his disciples. When the Sabbath came, he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard him were astonished. They said, "Where did this man get all this? What kind of wisdom has been given him? What mighty deeds are wrought by his hands? Is he not the carpenter, the son of Mary, and the brother of James and Joses, and Judas and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us?" And they took offense at him. Jesus said to them, "A prophet is not without honor except in his native place, and among his own kin and in his own house." So he was not able to perform any mighty deed there, apart from curing a few sick people and laying his hands on them. He was amazed at their lack of faith. The Gospel of the Lord.
Couple notes of business. One, Father Fernando's doing well. He has another procedure this coming week, so if you keep him in your prayers this coming Wednesday. And he just wants to thank everyone for your prayers and support during his time of healing. The other point of business is I want to thank Monsignor Patrick Bishop for the last 2 months for his time of coming out of retirement. And coming to help support the parish during the last couple of months between Father Fernando's departure and my arrival. So I want to thank him for all of his hard work. I also want to introduce, but he'll introduce himself more completely at the end of Mass, Father Miller to my left, who is your new vicar. So, the scriptures today. In today's gospel, we hear what I hope is not the case for someone returning home that could not work many mighty miracles or do anything because of the lack of faith. One of the pitfalls, because this is the second time that I've been at one place and come back, So I did it at Prince of Peace in Flowery Branch, from Buford to Flowery Branch, as vicar, then the pastor, and Transfiguration now from vicar to pastor. And one of the things that the people at Prince of Peace thought, it'll just be like when he was here before. And they were so wrong. So don't have that misconception. So where is the Lord calling us? Where is the Lord calling us? He's calling us on a journey. And the journey is to entrust our lives to the Holy Spirit, to truly give our hearts and our very lives to what God is calling us to in our life, both individually and collectively as the parish of the feast or the Catholic Church of the Transfiguration. That's what we're called to do. In today's scriptures, we hear the need to open our hearts. Then the first reading, some of the people were hard to hear what was being said by the prophet, and their hearts were hardened. We need to open our hearts. We need to look at what God is trying to do in our lives and be open to what God is saying. And our response always is simply a yes to the call of God. The voice of God is always speaking to us, always. That's not a question. The question comes in as to whether or not we're willing to listen. If we're open to what God is trying to tell us, one of the things people often tell me in the spiritual direction is, God doesn't speak to me. Then shut up. We need to be quiet to listen to the voice of God. So often as Catholics, we love to say our prayers and we talk a lot. And then we say amen, we close the book, we close the Bible, and we move on, or close our app, and we say, okay, we're done. And God's going, what about what I have to say? What about what I want to share with you? In those moments, God is speaking. God speaks to us through other people, through other prophetic voices. Even the perfect stranger that we see on the street can perhaps be the voice of God to us. We just need to listen. And one of the most important things we do in the spiritual life is surrender. And one of the most difficult things we do in the spiritual life is surrender. Because it's so hard not to be what? In control. Many of us like to be in control. We like to manage everything. We like to have everything programmed, put in its place. Managed. And if we're really living by the Holy Spirit, then that's not in control. We're not in control. I was listening to a podcast yesterday, and a bishop was quoted as saying in his prayer life that God had spoke to him very clearly. In that prayer that God spoke to him, he said, God said, you don't work for me, I don't work for you. You work for me. Now that's very hard for any of us to hear, especially a bishop. We need to listen to what God is trying to share with us. And we need to keep our eyes fixed on him. Sometimes we get so distracted in the midst of busyness and craziness of life that we get very, very distracted because we lose our focus, we're moving on something else or something like squirrel. We move our eyes and we move our focus back to something that isn't important. And the moment that we lose our focus on God is the moment that we're going to be lost, both in word and in sacrament. That's why we come here, is to be renewed and refreshed so we can go forth into the world to share the good news of Jesus Christ. We also have to understand ourselves. We are a sinful people. We make mistakes again and again and again. We're a people in need of God's loving and amazing mercy. But the moment we think we have all the answers and we know everything that needs to be known, we will falter. because then we're no longer relying on the help and promises of God. Where are we going as a parish? I don't know. But we are going on a journey. We will move. One of the things I've already heard from some rumors on the street, and yes, I do still hear rumors on the street from this parish, is that what's he going to do? Are we still going to be just like Transfiguration? Now, I have no idea what that means to that person that said this, but we're going to follow what it means to be transfigured. We are going to change. We are going to move. We are going to grow in our relationship with Jesus Christ. That's the journey that we're called on as the Christian disciples, and that's the journey that we're called to be on in our relationship with Christ as a parish. We will move. Guided by the Holy Spirit, constantly saying yes to where the Holy Spirit is calling us. How that's going to be done, what that's going to look like, I don't know. But we're going to do it together with an awful lot of discernment and prayer, seeking the voice of God in our lives. But God has work for us to do. We should never sit back and become content. He's always calling us deeper in that relationship with Him every day. I don't claim to have all the wisdom or answers. We will make this journey together, seeking the voice of God in all things. I ask for your prayers. Both Father Miller and I ask for your prayers and support and understanding as we move down the path that God has called us to follow. We have much work to do. Not because of anything that's gone on here before, not because of any past pastors or anything, not because I'm your new pastor. Simply by the fact we have work to do, simply because of the fact that we are Christian people on journey, being called by God to grow closer to Him. And in doing so, we will change and affect our lives will be changed and affected, and then we will be able to better preach, teach, and live the good news of Jesus Christ, proclaimed in word and in action in our daily lives. It's a journey. And you know what? It's a lifelong journey. There's no retirement as Christian disciples. The only retirement has is when we're laying in the casket like this. That's retirement. Until then, we're called to live every day the good news of Jesus Christ, that the Son of God came amongst us, gave us an example of how to live. He suffered, died, and rose again so that we might have life eternal. And why did He do all that? Because He loves us. That's the good news. And that's the good news we are called to proclaim every day of our lives. And what that journey looks like in the future, I don't know. All I know is that I'm called to follow what God is calling me to in my life. As a person, and as a pastor of this parish family. You know, I think one of the pitfalls that many of us have, especially in Atlanta, it seems, that all of us are the perfect driver. That somehow we all know how to do everything right and no one else does. Right? Am I the only one that has this problem? And I'm very willing to share my wisdom with other drivers. But they never, ever listen. The problem is, we're just perfect drivers until the moment we make the next mistake. And then we're like, oh, I'm so sorry, oh, forgive me. Or sometimes when someone beeps at us, we're like, pointing the way to heaven. We don't know everything. We don't have all the answers. And we're not yet perfected in our lives. We're not perfect. We're a sinful people on journey, relying on the mercy and love of God to bring us further and closer along the journey to Him. May we always be willing to be on this journey to love Him more deeply, to live out the life that He has called us to live, and to share the good news of Jesus Christ to those entrusted to us and to those that we have yet even to meet. May we be the people of God He has called us to be, to love, to forgive, and to bathe in His abiding presence every day. And let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. God, the Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, And let us now offer our prayers to God, who is our Almighty Father.
And our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the Catholic Church, may we see ourselves as called to do God's work for justice and peace. We pray especially for those who serve in missions around the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish, may we faithfully respond to our baptismal call to be the face of Christ to those we encounter in daily living, especially the families who are staying with us through the Family Promise program. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the many needs in our world, for those struggling to survive in war-torn areas or countries filled with violence, and for nations that still have uncontrollable COVID infections and death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country, may we once again become a beacon of hope, a beacon of light to other nations. We pray for those who are bent on tearing our country apart, pitting American against American because of ethnicity or religious differences. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, we pray also for all who are suffering in any way. May their faith and our support help them to experience hope and healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of Jack Lugo, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Sue Smith, Chris Roundtree, Libby Roundtree, Ilva Pichon, Lucia de Buitrago, and Debbie Miller, receive the faithfully departed into the light of your presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for your own intentions, held in the silence of your heart.
Compassionate and merciful God, give us faith in you that we might always live or welcome the stranger and aid the destitute. Giving of ourselves in your name, hear these prayers and grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands.
May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God, for you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children, the poor, for the sick and the sinner. He became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race, who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when as once the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread. He said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took a chalice. He gave you thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and to the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
Preach yours, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory John, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone had known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our early pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And so we now pray as our Savior taught us. Our deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we'll always be free from sin, safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Dear friends, let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
If you're joining us for this Mass online, please pray this prayer at this time. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Of the day and of the night.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. And now please join us as we sing a prayer for our country.
Father Eric said in the homily, my name is Father Miller Gomez. I am originally from Colombia. I came with Father Eric from Prince of Peace in Flowery Branch. I was ordained as a priest last year on June 27, and I come to serve this community of Transfiguration with joy and great hope and confidence that the Lord will give the graces that I need and that He will continue to be by my side. Please pray for me and Father Eric so that we can be the priests that the Lord wants us to be, so we can serve each of you in the way that the Lord wants and you need. Thank you very much.
So Father Miller and I came together because the priest that followed me at Prince of Peace is Hispanic, and so they didn't need two Hispanic or Spanish-speaking priests at one parish. So I asked the Archbishop and Father Miller if they would be willing to, he would be willing to come, and the Archbishop would be okay with him coming with me as a team. So Father Miller said yes, because Father Miller always says yes. he said yes, and the Archbishop agreed, so that's why we came as a team. Last night and today, I'm sure I broke 20 liturgical rules here at Transfiguration. So please be patient with me, just, and Father Miller, just relax. In Spanish, they say tranquilo. You know, just relax. It'll be all right. You know, we'll get into a groove, and everything will be fine. So I know things tend to be very directed. So just relax. I tend to go with the flow. My liturgical director at my last parish, he would say, we'll practice this. He would tell the people we're practicing for some liturgy. He goes, we'll practice this, but what Father Eric does, I don't know. So we'll be fine. We'll get along. Everything will be fine. The Eucharist, the body and blood of Christ, will still be confected. And the bread and wine will become the body and blood of Christ at the altar. Word will still be proclaimed, and the Lord will still be glorified. So please be patient as we just be patient, all right? The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. My dear friends, this Mass has ended. Go forth and preach the gospel with your life.
Thanks be to God.